On September 28, 2023, the Constitutional Court, in a majority decision of 4 justices against 1, ruled that the then Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Anita Mong, who presided over the censure of Commissioner of Parliament Francis Zakhe, violated the principles of natural justice by not recusing herself as the complainant. The court quashed his censure and ordered his reinstatement. However, 1 month later, Zakhe was not reinstated until today, when he was accompanied by his lawyers to storm Parliament. However, the embattled legislator wasn't successful after he found his former office locked by a strange lock pad. He spoke to the press and condemned Parliament leadership for violating court orders.
Very unfortunate, even when it's not surprising, that Parliament is not following the law. Again, it has not followed the law. The court ruled that Parliament doesn't follow the law, and it actually promised from their own letter, even on the social media handles of Parliament, they promised to heed to the law.
Zakhe described what he called a witch hunt from administration of Parliament, which according to him is behind his recent troubles that saw him sent back to the disciplinary committee of the House.
A lot of questions to the leadership of this Parliament, especially to Madam Speaker. What did I do wrong to you? Do you have a grudge on me? Do you have anything wrong with me? If you have it, please address to the public. If you do not have it, obey the laws.
The Mithiana municipality representative threatened to spill fraud taking place in the commission of the August Assembly should they fail to grant him access to his office.
I'm going to begin exposing each and every rot that is in the commission, because that may be the reason as to why you don't want me to get in, because I represent my party.
However, the Parliament mouthpiece Chris Obore noted that Zakhe's fate is before the Supreme Court after the Attorney General filed a notice of appeal of the judgment of the Constitutional Court. He added that the Attorney General also secured the stay of execution order, which restrains Zakhe from retaining his office pending Supreme Court decision.
The Attorney General informed us, Parliament, that he had appealed the ruling. And since he informed us, he has not given Parliament further guidance on what to do. And according to him, to Parliament, he had appealed and got in lawyers, a stay of execution. So that is the situation that Parliament knows.
Obore noted that the legislator was granted another office space at Kingdom Kampala Building in his other capacity as an MP.
Knowing that Honorable Zakhe is still a bona fide member of Parliament, deserving of an office, the clerk to Parliament went ahead and temporarily allocated him office space where other members are given offices. That is at Kingdom Building, Kampala Kingdom. So he has an office to operate as this matter is being handled by the courts of law.
The position of the Commissioner of Parliament comes with a hefty package of well-furnished office space with a personal secretary, a driver, vehicle, bodyguard, and a domestic worker. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.